Right, this is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. In this episode, I'm going to share with you guys the number one resource you guys want to pick up near you that's going to build your garden. And today in my city, I'm actually at the University of Nevada Cooperative Extension. It's 4400 Horse Drive, and they're open to the public Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday from 8 a.m. to noon. It's just past noon, and they locked the gates already, so don't get here too late. Don't get here at 11 and expect to get this valuable resource for yourself. You want to get here early. Anyways, I'm going to go around to the back of the lot and show you guys this free, amazing resource. Now, before you get this free, amazing resource here, you want to stop and check in with somebody and see what's going on. You also might want to call them at 702-786-4361 to actually make sure this resource is available, because many times of the year, they may run out because all the gardeners and people know how valuable it is. So let's head back and find out about it. This is what I am so excited about. It's actually all the free wood chips that you can get here. Now, if you don't have a place like the Master Gardener's Orchard here in Las Vegas, or you live somewhere else, that's all right. You can always find some free wood chips near you. Number one, you want to check with your local recycling company that like takes the green bins, if you have those, if you know what those are. Some places will take those and then put them off site. Maybe they'll give away the mulch for free. Maybe they will turn it into compost. You know, sometimes when I've seen the compost for sale, it's really just mulch. So check that out. The next way is to call an arborist near you. You know, arborists will trim trees. They take the trees, they put it through their shredder, and they make tons of wood chips. Luckily here in town, sometimes they drop the wood chips here so that you can pick them up for free yourself. If you want to get them loaded into the truck, they'll do it for just, you know, I don't know, $5 or something, and dump a load into your truck for you guys. I'm going to basically bag this stuff up, because if they load it into a truck, then when you get home, you got to unload it. I'm just going to load it into bags now for the most part, and then be able to take the bags out and then just dump them where I need them. So that's going to save me time unloading instead of loading. So it's like, where do you want your time to be taken up at, loading or unloading? So that's why I always like to use feed sack bags. You could also use something like plastic totes, or even some very well-taped cardboard boxes, or even some really heavy-duty garbage bags. But don't load them up too much, because they will break. The other way you can learn about free wood chips near you is a website called chipdrop.com. And now here's the thing. I want to let you guys know that with free wood chips, there's pros and cons. Anything in life, there's pros and cons, right? With the free wood chips, you're getting them free. It costs you zero money. The bad thing is the quality may not be the best, and you don't get to choose exactly what kind of chips you get to pick up. I mean, I could go to a local landscape soil company here, and they have a couple really nice, you know, looking chips that might be good for, you know, good looks if you're doing it in your front yard. But surely for my backyard, you know, I'm just going to get some regular old wood chips. And wood chips to a gardener are an essential ingredient. I mean, to me, wood chips are like gold for a gardener, especially here in the desert where organic matter is sparse. And wood chips are basically organic matter and basically concentrated sources of carbon that can beneficially impact your garden in a number of ways. And the cool thing here is they've actually have different piles of wood chips. So I'm gonna go around to each of the different piles and show you guys how I would personally use each of the piles in my yard, or what you can do with the wood chips in your yard. So let's come along.
So let's go ahead and walk up to the wood chip piles. You can see there's a bunch of different piles. And here's the thing, you know, at different times, different arborists may drop off different piles. So some piles are older, some piles are newer. And you know, each of the piles has a different mixture of materials that I'll talk to you guys about. So you got to think about, what am I going to use the wood chips for? Am I just going to use the wood chips to mulch my fruit trees and put as a ground layer to protect the soil? Then I'd want to get one that has a lot more wood material without a lot of leaf material. Since we are here in the desert and pine is a really thing that's grown a lot, pine trees, a lot of these chips also have pine needles in them. There's a couple nice piles that are more wood content, and there's even some piles with some leaf content. So I'm gonna go around to some of the different piles and share with you guys what I would do them. For me, the pile I want, when I seen this pile on the top, I'm like, these are the pile I gotta get, because I'm using them for basically protect my soil in my pathways, which is an excellent use, so I could keep the mud and dirt and the dirt blowing around in my garden. Plus, they'll break down over time and create really rich, fertile soil. And so, like, yeah, these nice blonde wood chips with pretty much almost all wood content are the ones I'm getting. The other thing you want to pay attention to is you want to pay attention to the cut of the wood chip, right? Some arborists have chippers that maybe the blades are more dull and some are more sharp, so some are gonna be more shredded and some are actually be more like a chip. And for me, I personally like the ones physically that look more like a chip myself. And of course, if you're using them for gardening purposes, many times you're gonna wanna get the most broken down chips.
If you guys really want the lowdown on the wood chips, I would recommend you guys watch another video I made below in Texas where I really go over with a soil expert about the different quality of wood chips and which ones you should use for mulch. Of course, I've visited him and I've visited a lot of places. I've seen wood chips being used in many ways. And in this video, I'm gonna share with you guys my personal opinions. So, you know, as I said, these are the chips that I'm getting today because there's very little leaf matter or, you know, needle matter in there. It's basically mostly wood chips and it looks like they had a pretty good sharp cutter. Plus, I like that these are actually blonde. Some, you know, woods will be a lot darker, some will be a lot lighter. I like these are blonde because it just brightens up my backyard, all my pathways that I'll be putting down today. So, you know, these are the kind of wood chips I personally would choose if I had like a fruit tree orchard and I was mulching below them. Of course, you could use anything. Any of the different wood chips would totally work, but I prefer the ones that are mostly woody material without a lot of the green matter in there. What eats the carbon? What eats the wood chips up, right? It is the fungi, and the fungi are super important for your garden. Most standard compost piles that you would have in your yard are bacterial-based compost, and that's great. Most gardeners have an excess of a bacterial-based, you know, microbes in their garden, but don't have enough fungi. So, you know, by putting the wood chips down in a nice layer in Phoenix, they might do even a foot of wood chips. It could also help, you know, keep the moisture into the ground, you know, remediate the different temperature extremes, hold water, and create a nicer soil environment for all the different microbes. If the wood chips are kept moist, then fungi will find their way in. And if we just simply dig in here a little bit, you know, in the back of the pile, you know, I'll find like white strands, and that's like, you know, fungi growing in there. I wish there were some fungirls hanging out here in the pile too that I could maybe take home. Since I'm single, maybe I'll meet a fun girl shoveling wood chips one day. The other way you could use these wood chips, and in my opinion, the most valuable way is to get, once again, you know, mostly chips without any kind of leaf material in there, and just take them home and put them into a pile, a 3-foot by 3-foot pile, and let it sit there for like 3 years. If you want to look up you know, a way to do it more specifically than that, you can look up Sue Johnson bioreactor. That's a definitely good way to increase a lot of fungal matter. You could, you know, put air tubes in there. I'm not gonna get into that, but basically the easy way is just pile up these wood chips, leave it sit for 3 years, and especially here in an arid climate, you will need to water it regularly to keep it moist. You could even impregnate it with King Strepharia mushrooms or other mushrooms, although, you know, there's already some fungi growing in here that will probably take over, because, you know, when you have a pile of wood chips sitting around and there's moisture, guess what? The fungi that live in there will find it and live in it. Like if you had an abandoned house, right, and there's a lot of homeless people and the door was open, they would go in there and they would start living because it's a home, and that's what the fungi are gonna do. So number one way to use the wood chips, most valuable in my opinion, is to basically pile them up and let them decompose with fungi for a good 3 years, and that's gonna be some good fungal dominated soil. And this is very difficult because literally money can't almost not buy this, depending where you are, because it's not really widely available. And it's unfortunately not very commonly talked about in gardening. Of course, the other way is you could use this as a mulch for your trees. I personally would not use this as a mulch for my vegetable garden. I would not want the wood to get mixed in with my garden soil. So I'm gonna show you guys the mulch I would use if I was going to mulch my garden. So how convenient, the pile right next to the wood pile is this pile. And in this pile, there's lots of pine needles. You know, in some areas of the country they may sell pine needle mulch. Why buy pine needle mulch at a nursery for lots of money when you could come here and you get basically pine needle mulch for free? This is the kind of mulch I would use if I was gonna do it in my vegetable garden. Number one, they're acidic, and especially here in the desert, you know, the soils tend to be more alkaline, especially when you're watering with literally alkaline water due to the mineral content. Plus, this will help keep your moisture in the ground. You know, of course, I prefer to do more of a living mulch where I plant things so densely and so close, you know, the sun does not have the opportunity to hit the ground. And then also I top off all my raised beds with some good composted mixture every day that I use as my mulch. I'm currently experimenting with other kinds of mulch, such as cocoa hull mulch. So what you guys are seeing now is more of an all-purpose mulch. You know, if you want to use your mulch to compost in a bacterial-based pile, you want to try to look for a pile that has both carbon and nitrogen sources. You know, in this pile, there happens to be like some leaves that are kind of broken up, as well as the wood chips. So this is a really nice mixture of wood chips and leaves. And this is the one I would use if you want to just take this home and compost yourself. In addition, you know, they have a pile of horse manure that you could pick up and add the horse manure to this stuff, compost it yourself to make your own garden soil, right? We want to reuse these resources that normally would just get thrown away at the dumps to benefit you. And there is no substitute for organic matter. You could not ever have enough organic matter in your garden. The next thing I want to talk about is if you are looking for high microbial action, like you're going to use this actively for growing in or next to your raised bed, I would encourage you guys to pick a pile that is more fresh than more old. We're here at the back of the lot, and this is the oldest pile that's been sitting out in the sun in the arid climate, and all the moisture basically wicks out. So if you could just dig down, this stuff is bone dry. This could be good for some certain applications, but not for any of my applications. So you always want to look for more fresh, you know, chips that actually have moisture, because that is where the fungi, and you're going to have more microbial activity. So this was the very spot that I was digging in to get my wood chips. And I don't know if you guys could see it on the HD camera, but if we pull out these chips, they're actually quite moist. And if you look closely, you can see some like white hairs on there. This is microbial growth, fungal growth. This is some definitely good stuff because it's nice and broken down. Also, if you guys are looking for more of a beauty mulch like I was today, right, the top of the piles tend to get more dry. So when the piles dry out, it's gonna look like this nice blonde mulch. And then down below where it's still moist, you know, it's gonna be a little bit darker. You know, I surmise that, you know, this stuff will dry out and will look more light like the stuff on top. That being said, be aware that even in one pile, there may be different trees that are chipped in that one pile. Like an arborist could have went to house A, chipped a bunch of stuff, and the back of the truck had certain trees, and then the front of the truck has a different mixture. So you always want to be aware when you're digging out the mulch, if you want a certain mixture, you know, to see what it's looking like. And to me, this is like really nice mulch here that's broken down well, that's got nice fungal activity. So as I'm sitting here amongst the mulch, you learn some of the ways you guys could use the mulch. If you want to get the newer mulch or older mulch, how you can decompose it to make fungal dominated compost, you know, how you can use it to mulch your gardens to protect your soil. Super critical, super important. And now I want to get into some advanced tips. Most people just come here and pick up their mulch and then go home, right? You know, one of the things you could do is you could bring a screen. So now you can select for certain size diameter materials. So for example, when I loaded up my car today, I would have liked to have about a 1-inch screen, because I want to get all the fine little wood chips, because it's a, you know, I'm using them for beauty looks, and I don't really want big sticks. Likewise, you know, if you are wanting to break the chips down, turn that into soil, you know, smaller particle sizes like sawdust sizes are more effective at breaking down more quickly. So you won't even might want to have a 1/2-inch or 1/4-inch screen to get all the fines to use in composting. You know, for me, I compost all my food scraps and yard waste, which is high nitrogen content. And in the desert, it is very difficult to get a good carbon source. So I was buying some compressed pellets that they normally use for horse bedding. And then I now switched to shredding up my cardboard. But if I wanted to get a free source without buying a shredder of carbon, I would come here with a 1/4-inch screen and then screen out this stuff to get the smallest particle size, because that's gonna have basically more surface area for the microbes and bacteria to act upon when I mix it, you know, in my compost, my standard bacterial-based compost pile. For me, I want to screen out the big stuff so it'd have actually nice beauty compost, but you know, depending on what you want, you might wanna screen it out to a different size, and that's one of the things you'll get going to a landscape yard where you could buy the mulch. They've already screened it for you, so it's all looking really nice. Now, the final thing I'd like to say about wood chips is, You want to be wary of wood chips, especially free ones, right? Most times the arborist will just drop off the chips and they don't know how the trees were treated, what they were sprayed, if there were pesticides or fungicides sprayed upon there. And you know, I've heard reports where people will buy, get a big chip, drop of wood chips, put them down, and then their trees will, their tree health will suffer, and they believe it is because of the wood chips. So always be careful. That being said, you know, they use the wood chips here at the Master Gardener's Orchard to line the whole base, which is what they should do at other farms here in the Las Vegas Valley, but don't. I do not believe that they've lost a tree due to the wood chips that have been used here on site, although I might be wrong. I think the last thing I want to do is I want to show you guys actually how to load the wood chips in your car without owning a truck. So now I want to show you guys actually how you can load up your own wood chips if you have like a hatchback car, or even if you don't. I don't want you to be constrained. Think, I can't get wood chips because I don't have a truck. Well, you could go out and rent a truck. You could find a friend with a truck and borrow his truck or her truck. I don't own a truck. I got to be able to load wood chips with what I've got. So, you know, once again, as I mentioned before, they could dump it in your truck, you could drive it home, and then you could unload it by wheelbarrow and then deal with them and then put them where they need to be. I would rather do the labor on this end because when I get home, I don't really feel like do much else. So I've already loaded it into basically feed sack bags, and these actually have nice ties on them. So this feed sack bag is completely full. I could just pick this up, take it to where I need it, open the tie, and dump it out in my yard to cover all my pathways. That's gonna make it really simple and easy, and that's gonna keep my car really clean. As I said before, you could also use a tote, a cardboard box, maybe even some really strong garbage cans, plastic garbage cans to do that. And as I said before, you might wanna screen it depending on your specific use. Now, the other thing I've done besides loading up the feed sack bags is I put a big tarp down, and the bigger tarp, the better, because you wanna protect the interior of your car, because these guys will get everywhere and they do not easily come out of carpet. So I basically put a tarp down up the sides of my car and basically just scoop this in. So I got the bags up in the front, and then I got this stuff in the back so I could take more material home so I could, you know, make less trips. So, you know, there's always a way to get some wood chips today. Wood chips are probably one of the most valuable assets that you guys can get to build up your garden. So I want you guys to go out and find some wood chips after you guys watch this video and figure out how you will use them. I may have videos on other free resources, like they're making compost out of horse manure and coffee grounds here. You know, if you go to a juice bar, you can get lots of green waste or juice pulp that you can mix with the wood chips to compost. Brewery mash from breweries, all different kinds of waste materials that you can repurpose to use to add organic matter into your garden. And you know, these are some of the best things we could do to divert things going to the landfill, because surely here in the desert, the landfill basically just gets buried, and probably in 100 years you could dig it up and find whole plastic toys and whatnot, which I think is a waste. So yeah, we want to reuse and divert things like wood chips and use them to build your garden so you guys can grow better food. If you guys like this episode, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up and be sure to share this with other people so that they can learn about the number one most valuable resource you guys could get for free near you, which is the wood chips. Be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on my new upcoming episodes. I've come out every 5 to 7 days. You never know where I'll show up or what you'll be learning on my YouTube channel so that you can grow a better garden. Make sure you click the bell so you get notified as my new videos come out. And finally, be sure to check my past episodes, including the video I mentioned at the beginning of this video on the best mulch to use and the different kinds of wood chips, where I go into a soil with a soil scientist more in depth about the benefits of using the wood chips and the different kinds of mulch you may want to use. Link down below for that. So with that, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. Until then, remember, keep on growing.